I'm sorry I haven't a clue, the antidote to panel games. At the piano is Colin Sell, and your chairman is Jack D.
Hello and welcome to I'm Sorry I Haven't a Clue. You join us this week on our visit to the historic city of Leicester. In 2012, the remains of Richard III were discovered under a Leicester City Council car park. The excavation revealed that sometime after he died at the Battle of Bosworth, Richard's body was dumped there without ceremony. DNA samples have helped trace his descendants, who've been fined for fly tipping. In the 19th century, Leicester became a major manufacturing centre engaged in shoemaking. In 1855, the city's mayor boasted that Leicester had more people making shoes than the rest of Britain put together. Historians now agree that was a lot of cobblers. Obviously, a lot of these jokes are for a dare, you know. Around the turn of the 20th century, the Leicester-based writer James Arnold decided to produce a book called 100 Things to Do Before You Die. On its publication in 1912, most of his readers missed out on 99 of them, as the first thing on the list was to take a luxury cruise to New York aboard an unsinkable ocean liner. According to the City Council's online events page, in 2017, Leicester is hotly tipped to become UK's City of Culture. So congratulations to whichever hoaxer hacked into that website. Leicestershire is world famous for its pork pies. A recent EU... we've got one in, have we? A recent EU ruling on food origins means that only pies made in the correct way within a designated zone are allowed to carry the Melton Mowbray name. Genuine Melton pies can contain only uncured pink pork surrounded by pale grey pastry with the gaps filled with brown jellified fat drained from reduced offal. The precise recipe is kept secret under the Public Health Act of 1947. The inventor of Scrabble was born in Leicester. Alfred Morris made his first set of Scrabble tiles in 1947, laboriously hand-carving them from cow bone. Unfortunately, his dog ate them. And then a few hours later, the dog started leaving little messages around the house. George Bancart was born here in 1866. After leaving the Leicester School of Art, he took up decorative plasterwork, moulding fine pieces for public buildings. One intended for the new town hall in 1914 was never used as the war intervened. This moulding was recently taken out of storage and is displayed in the Leicester Museum. But that's not the only place you can find an obscure cast that no one's seen for years. Let's meet the teams. On my left, Barry Cryer and Graeme Garden. And on my right, Tim Brooke-Taylor and Rob Brydon. And please welcome the lovely lady who lends a hand when the team's points are on the up, our scorer, the delightful Samantha. Okay, our first round this week is about books. Not all books are assured of success, so teams, I'd like you please to suggest titles of books which would be guaranteed to flop. Graeme, maybe you could start us off.
Big Women.
Rob?
Bridget Jones's Diarrhea.
Tim?
50 Shades of Gravy.
Barry?
The Joy of Socks.
Alice in Sunderland.
King Solomon's Yours.
Okay,
The Great Catspy.
Brave New World of Leather.
The Old Man and the CRB.
On the Origin of Feces.
The Witches of Gatwick.
The Wind in the Widows. Just a personal experience.
James Joyce's Useless.
Well, the teams are going to sing for us now in the game called One Song to the Tune of Another. Piano accompaniment will be provided by Colin Sell. Listeners will be interested to learn that Colin did very well at this year's Singer of the World competition. The judges said Colin's was one of the nicest sewing machines they'd ever seen. So we'll start with you, Barry. I'd like you to sing the words of Hit Me With Your Rhythm Stick to the tune of The Girl from Ipanema.
In the deserts of Sudan and the gardens of Japan, from Milan to Yucatan, every woman, every man, hit me with your rhythm stick. Hit me, je t'adore. Ich liebe dich. Hit me, hit me, hit me. Hit me with your rhythm stick. Hit me slowly, hit me quick. Of Borneo and the vineyards of Bordeaux, Eskimo Arapaho, move that body to and fro. Hit me with your rhythm stick. Hit me, hit me. Das is good. Say fantastic.
So you now, Tim, I'd like you to sing the words of Gordon is a Moron to the tune of Lily Marlene.
I've been going out with a girl, her name is Julie, but last night she said to me, when we were watching a telly, she said, listen, John, I love you, but there's this broke I fancy. I don't want to two-time you, so it's the end for you and me. Who's this bloke? I asked her. Gordon, she replied. Not that puff, I said, dismayed. Yes, but he's no puff, she cried. I know he's a moron. Gordon is a moron. Gordon is a moron, Gordon is a moron, but I know he's a moron. Gordon is a moron.
And, Graeme, now I'd like you to sing the words of My Ding-a-ling to the to the tune of She.
When I was a little bitty boy, my grandma bought me a cute little toy, two silver bells on a string. She told me it was my ding-a-ling, my ding-a-ling, my ling, my ding-a-ling. Won't you play with my ding-a-ling?
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.